Good evening. I hope you're doing well. How's your week going? I have a couple of things here. First one is this Naked Urban Decay palette. I was going to try to figure out which palette this is, but I don't know. This was in my other videos, and I had to bring it back because it sounds so good. I've had it for a couple of years. I honestly don't remember, but I try to use it as much as I can so that I can buy another one. Can you hear? Her name is Ladybird, and she's next to me, sleeping. next item is my lipstick. I like the Maybelline New York brand of lipstick. And this is Almond Hustle. This is a really good shade if you're warm toned like me, and also pretty fair skinned. It is so beautiful. I want to show you. Oh no, what happened? But it's just really a perfect shade for work, for dates, and it's just really beautiful. I tried another brand of lipstick from Target, and it did not smell or taste good, and I don't need my lipstick to smell good, I mean taste good, but if it smells bad, then I can't wear it, no matter how pretty the color is. So yeah, if you are looking for a good, kind of a stronger, mellowed tone, then this is a really good color. That was my fiance's dog. She's like a baby. Other colors that I have, or other shades from Maybelline, is Pink Wink. It's a very pink color, but it's not like bright pink. It's more pinkish red with like a purple undertone. Fiance's dog, Ladybird's breathing is soothing for you. She knows that I'm talking about her. She wakes up a little bit. For me, I don't see the value of buying the more expensive lipsticks. I don't know, I just can't justify spending $30 for a MAC lipstick. Then I think this one is like $6, $7. Don't wear lipstick enough, and I like to change my colors frequently, except this color is so good that I wear this color almost every time. Although better, like higher end lipsticks are, they probably smell better and go on more smoothly. But that's just me. The next item is my shea butter lip butter. Now, I got this a very long time ago from Bath and Body Works. It's the other store besides the Bath and Body Works. What is it called? Oh, the Body Shop. I think this is where it's from. It's really old, as you can tell. And I found this in one of my bags when I was cleaning my room. And the shea butter, I didn't use it all up because it wasn't that good. But I cleaned it all up, and now I have Vaseline in there. I love Vaseline for my lips. And actually, this is the last step of my nighttime routine. So I put Night of Olay sometimes with baby oil. And then I put Vaseline all over my face. Not everywhere, but focusing on my eyes, under my eyes, around my lips, and around my eyebrows. Because I think that's where a lot of people get, or where I'm prone to getting wrinkles. So I know it's not for everyone because Vaseline is very thick. Vaseline is one of those things that I'm always looking for. So I always put lotion after I wash my hands, and I always put Vaseline after I brush my teeth. card game that my fiance and I play. We play this a lot, and we play this so much that there's a crease on the card because we shuffle it so much. So this is a card game. And there are three main types of cards. There are action cards, like double the rent. There are property, and there's money. And you can play with two or more players. And the goal of the game is to is to collect three sets of properties. This is a really fun game, and when my fiancé and I shuffle, we divide the card in half. I shuffle half of it, and he shuffles the other half. And then halfway in between, we switch half of our half deck. And then at the very end, I collect all the cards, and then I shuffle the entire deck several times. Kind of hard to shuffle something that's this big. This kind of sounds like the Naked Palette. The last trigger is my county market max value card. I know it's really random. So I'm staying at my fiance's parents' home for about a month. And their home is close to a county market. So I went to county market yesterday. And some of their items were on sale with the coupon from the app. But I didn't have the app. I didn't have one of these. As a brand new card. It's been going to the grocery store quite often. I used to be someone who goes grocery shopping like once a week, like a big haul. But then when I do that, the food that I get goes bad, like especially things like cilantro or meat. Like if I don't cook the meat a couple of days after I buy it, I won't make it or cook with it because I'll think it's too old. But I live pretty close to the county market, so it's easy to go every day, and there's not too many people. It's not too big, and yeah, it's easy to go. It's not overwhelming. This county market has really good chicken tenders. Whenever I'm in the area, I'm always craving chicken tenders. County Market has really good chicken tenders. So I went to school, grad school, in this town where I'm at right now. It's in the Midwest. And my first year was 2013, so that was 9 years ago. And I used to live, actually, like, pretty close to where I am right now. And so, I used to drive to school, and on the way to school, there would be this county market. And so I would get the chicken tenders whenever I wanted it. And then when I started dating my fiancé, he was like, "Have you ever had the county market chicken tenders?" I was like, "Of course I have." But I didn't know that that was like the best chicken tenders in town. Someone who goes grocery shopping several times a week? Or do you go to one big haul? Or do you do like a meal delivery service? What do you do? I'm a dietitian, and I also love for me, cooking is love. It's like showing love for others. So I wanted to build a meal subscription service because how unique would that be? For someone with a dietetics background and someone who also loves cooking. But I can tell you that many dietitians love food and cooking. I will say that not every person with a nutrition degree, like a PhD in nutrition, I would say are less into food than dietitians. These are your favorites, so I have another. This is from earlier. The Almond Hustle. I honestly love anything with almonds. I think that's why I got this color. I was like, ooh, almond must be good. Like, I love Jamocha Almond Fudge ice cream from Baskin Robbins. I love Snickers with almonds. What else? I also love like almond scented things like candles. I also love chocolate with almonds. Milk chocolate. So before my fiance, I was dating someone who we lived together in the Bay Area of California, and we lived together 2 months after we started dating, which was a mistake, so don't do that. And so we moved in together January, early mid-January, and then Christmas that year, so it's already been almost over a year of dating, my ex got me dark chocolate on Christmas. Got my favorite biscuits, but it was with dark chocolate. And how would you feel if after a year of knowing someone and living with someone for most of that time, he got you dark chocolate? Because he didn't pay attention to the small details of what's called the love map. Now, my fiance is really good at things like that. Like, he'll notice, like, I'll like certain things. And then he'll get me that. For example, he knows that I like hot Cheetos, especially when I'm on my period. And he'll know what when it's that time. He's very sensitive. One of these are your favorite. See you next time.